In this segment, we are going to discuss an important theorem, which is the factor theorem. So before we discuss the factor theorem, let us list down the remainder theorem. So the remainder theorem said that if a polynomial f of x was divided by x minus a, then the remainder obtained was f of a. So, in our earlier segments, we saw that the remainder theorem was helpful in calculating the remainder when a given polynomial was divided by a linear divisor. Now, let's think about what happens if that remainder is zero, right? So, whenever I divide a number, so let's assume that I have the number 48. When I divide 48 by 8, so I know that 8 6s are 48. And the remainder is 0. So hence I can say that 8 is a factor of 48, right? And on what basis did I decide whether it was a factor or not? I decided based on the remainder that I obtained. So 8 is a factor of 48 is true only because the remainder is actually equal to 0. Similarly, let's check if 80 is a multiple of 12. So what we will do is we will divide 80 by 12. So 12 6s are 72 and the remainder is 8. Because the remainder is not 0, I can say that 12 is not a factor of 80. So the moral of the story is if the remainder is 0, then I can say that I have a factor, and if the remainder is not 0, then I know that the given divisor is not a factor of the given dividend. So let us apply this idea, or let us extend this idea in case of polynomials, and let us state the factor theorem. So the factor theorem says that if f of x is divided by x minus a, and if f of a is 0, then x minus a is a factor of f of x. So what we are saying is when I divide f of x by x minus a, right, when f of x is divided by x minus a, I know that the remainder that I obtain is f of a. This is the remainder obtained, and the remainder theorem states this, right? So if this remainder happens to be a zero, that is, if this f of a happens to be a 0, then I can say that x minus a, which is the divisor, then x minus a is a factor of the dividend, and the dividend is f of x in this particular case. So this is the statement of factor theorem. Now we need to understand the difference between the remainder theorem and the factor theorem, because most of the times students tend to use this interchangeably. See, the remainder theorem is helping you find the remainder. Okay, so whenever you have a linear divisor, if you are dividing a polynomial by a linear divisor, the remainder theorem will help you find the remainder. Now, if that remainder is 0, then the factor theorem helps you conclude that the divisor is indeed a factor of the dividend. Right? So now I'll take an example and I will show you the difference between the two. So look at the following question. Check if x minus 1 is a factor of the given polynomial. So now I do not know whether it is a factor, but I definitely know that. So let's take f of x is equal to x cube minus 5x square plus 6x minus 2. Now I know that if f of x is divided by x minus 1, then the remainder obtained is going to be f of 1, right? So which theorem states this? This is the remainder theorem. I do not know what my remainder is, so I am finding the remainder using the remainder theorem. So let me find f of 1. F of 1 is going to be, f of 1 means in place of x, I have to substitute a 1. So it is 1 cube minus 5 multiplied by 1 square plus 6 multiplied by 1 minus 2. That is 1 minus 5 plus 6 minus 2, and that is going to be equal to 0. So this means f of 1 is 0. Now, because the f of 1 is 0, okay, because the value of f of 1 is 0, so as f of 1 is equal to 0, I can now conclude that x minus 1 is a factor. X minus 1 is a factor of f of x. This is according to the factor theorem. So remainder theorem just helps me find the remainder, whereas factor theorem helps me conclude that the divisor is a factor of the given dividend. So this is the difference in the application of the two theorems. And now let us take up some more questions to solve that are related to the factor theorem. So this is the next question. Show that x plus 3 is a factor of 2x square minus x minus 21. Now there are two ways of solving this. One way is using the remainder factor theorem. So let's use the remainder factor theorem method first. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to assign, let f of x be equal to 2x square minus x minus 21. And now when f of x is divided by x plus 3, the remainder is given by f of minus 3, isn't it? Which theorem states this? This is the remainder theorem. Right? This is the remainder theorem. So therefore, let's find f of minus 3 now. F of x is 2x square minus x minus 21. And therefore, f of minus 3 is going to be 2 times negative 3 the whole square minus of minus 3 minus 21. So this is 2 times 9 plus 3 minus 21. That's 21 minus 21, which is equal to 0. So as f of minus 3 is 0, now I can conclude x plus 3 is a factor. X plus 3 is a factor of f of x, right? And which theorem states this? This is the factor theorem. Now they are asking me to factorize the given polynomial. So this is a quadratic expression. Quadratic expression or a quadratic polynomial will always have two factors. Therefore, I can write, 2x square minus x minus 21 when factorized can be written as x plus 3 is definitely one factor. And now I need to find the other factor, isn't it? There are going to be two factors because this is a quadratic polynomial. Now, how do I find this second factor? One method is definitely the long division method. So let us use the long division method. So I have 2x square minus x minus 21 divided by x plus 3. Now let's find the quotient. X multiplied by 2x becomes 2x square, and 3 multiplied by 2x becomes 6x. Now I ought to subtract. So let me shift the signs of the second column, second row. So minus x minus 6x is minus 7x minus 21. Now x multiplied by negative 7 becomes negative 7x negative 21. And now I will shift the signs of the second row again. So this becomes positive and this becomes positive. Therefore the answer is 0. And that's obvious because x plus 3 is a factor of the given polynomial. So the remainder should be 0. And now the second factor is 2x minus 7. Now, sometimes you can also bypass the complete remainder factor theorem and just use the long division to prove that it is a factor. So I would just divide 2x square minus x minus 21 by x plus 3. And since the remainder is 0, I can say that the binomial x plus 3 is a factor of the given polynomial. And then I also get the second factor from the division process. So that's an alternate way of doing the same question. So let me pause the screen for a couple of minutes and then I will continue. Okay, let us now go to our next question. Okay, this is our next question. Show that x minus 1 is a factor of this given expression. Factorize the given polynomial completely. This is a cubic polynomial. So cubic polynomial means the degree of this polynomial is 3. Because the degree of this polynomial is 3, it is going to have 3 factors. So let me first show that x minus 1 is a factor of the given polynomial. So let f of x, I'm going to use the factor theorem, the remainder and the factor theorem in this question. So this is the given x, f of x. Now when f of x is divided by x minus 1, when f of x is divided by x minus 1, the remainder is f of 1, and it is not the factor theorem which states this, it is the remainder theorem, right? So because I don't know whether it is a factor or not, I cannot use the factor theorem here, but I definitely know that on dividing this polynomial by x minus 1, the remainder is f of 1. So let's find f of 1. F of 1 would mean in f of x, wherever I see a x, I have to substitute a 1. So this is 1 cube minus 7 into 1 square plus 14 times 1 minus 8. So that is 1 minus 7 plus 14 minus 8. That's 15 minus 15, which is indeed equal to 0. So because f of 1 is 0, as f of 1 is 0, now I can conclude that x minus 1 is a factor. X minus 1 is a factor of f of x, and now this is according to the factor theorem. Now what I have to do is I have to factorize the given expression. So I know that f of x can be written as, there are going to be 3 factors because this is a cubic expression. So these are the 3 factors. X minus 1 happens to be one of the factors. Therefore, to find the other 2 factors, I am again going to use the long division. So x cube. Let's now perform long division based on the given polynomials. So I have x cube minus 7x square plus 14x minus 8. This whole thing is divided by the divisor. So what is the divisor? The divisor in this case is x minus 1. So now let's perform the long division. X into x square gives me x cube, and minus 1 into x square gives me minus x square. So now again I go ahead and I subtract. So let's perform the subtraction operation, right? So the sign negates and the sign becomes positive here. So a positive sign becomes negative and a negative sign becomes positive. This is happening because we are subtracting the two polynomials. So minus 7x square plus x square is minus 6x square plus 14x minus 8. Now x multiplied by minus 6 gives me minus 6x square, and minus 1 into minus 6x becomes plus 6x. So again let's perform the subtraction operation. So a negative sign will turn into a positive sign, and a positive sign turns into a negative sign. Negative 6x square plus 6x square is 0. 14x minus 6x is 8x minus 8. Now x multiplied by 8 will give me 8x, and minus 1 multiplied by 8 is going to give me minus 8. So now again when I subtract, I will have to switch the signs because I am subtracting. So I get a remainder of 0. So I now know that f of x, let us perform the factorization here. So I now know that the given f of x can be written as x minus 1 multiplied by x square minus 6x plus 8. So now this is a trinomial. I know how to factorize the trinomial using the splitting the middle term method. So I need two numbers whose product is 8 and sum is negative 6, right? Product is the product of the two extreme terms, whereas the middle term is my sum. So obviously the two numbers are minus 4 and minus 2. So therefore this is equal to x minus 1 times, let's split the middle term, x square minus 4x minus 2x plus 8. So therefore this becomes x minus 1 into, I can take a x common, so x into x minus 4, and I can take a minus 2 common from here, so minus 2 times x minus 4, and therefore the two factors are x minus 4 and x minus 2. And hence the three factors of f of x are, so the factors of f of x are x minus 1, comma x minus 4 and x minus 2. Now of course you can also write f of x in this form, that is x minus 1 into x minus 4 into x minus 2. So if you actually open up these brackets, you should get back your original polynomial. So in this problem we use the remainder theorem to first prove that one term is a factor, right? To prove that x minus 1 was a factor. Then we divide it to find our quotient, and then we factorize the quotient to find the other two factors. So again, let me pause for some time so that you can take a look at what was done, and then we will go on to our next problem. Okay, let us now take some more problems on factor theorem. So let's consider these two questions now. The fourth one says, find the value of a if x minus a is a factor of the given polynomial. So we are given that f of x is equal to x cube minus ax square plus x plus 2. And now here in this question, it is given that x minus a is a factor, right? So since x minus a is a factor, since it's given that x minus a is a factor, I can say that f of a is equal to 0 according to the factor theorem. Because the factor theorem said that if my f of a was 0, then x minus a was a factor, which means the converse also holds true. So if x minus a is a factor, then the factor theorem helps me conclude that f of a should be equal to 0. So let us now find f of a. So f of a is equal to 0 is known. Now what is f of a? It means in place of x, I have to substitute a. So a cube minus a into a square plus a plus 2 is equal to 0. This means a cube minus a cube plus a plus 2 is equal to 0. A cube minus a cube cancels and therefore a equals negative 2. So this is how we found the value of a, in this particular question. Let us now solve the fifth one. Find the value of k if, for what value of k is this polynomial? So let us define the polynomial. F of x is defined as x cube plus 3x square minus kx plus 10, right? This is the defined polynomial. For what value of k? So we are supposed to find the value of k. Is this a multiple of x minus 2? So it's given that f of x is a multiple of x minus 2, which implies that x minus 2 is a factor. X minus 2 is a factor of f of x. And therefore, by factor theorem, I can say that f of 2 should be equal to 0. This is by the factor theorem. Now, f of 2 would mean in place of x, I have to substitute 2. So, 2 cube plus 3 into 2 square minus k into 2 plus 10 should be 0. 2 cube is 8 plus 2 square is 4, 3s are 12. Minus 2k plus 10 is equal to 0. That means from this equation, we conclude that k is equal to 15. Okay. And that's why this polynomial now becomes, so if I were to write this polynomial becomes, therefore f of x becomes x cube plus 3x square minus 15x plus 10, right? This is the polynomial because I have replaced k with 15. Now I have to find, is x plus 1 a factor of this polynomial? So now let us find out whether x plus 1 is a factor or not. According to the remainder theorem, I can say that if f of x is divided by x plus 1, then the remainder is given by f of minus 1. And please note that this is the remainder theorem, not the factor theorem, right? The remainder theorem helps me find the remainder. Now let's find f of minus 1. F of minus 1 would mean in this polynomial, I have to substitute minus 1 everywhere. So it is minus 1 the whole cube plus 3 into minus 1 the whole square minus 15 into minus 1 plus 10. So minus 1 the whole cube is minus 1. Minus 1 the whole square is 1. These are 3. Plus 15 plus 10. You will notice that this value is not equal to 0. The remainder is not 0. So because the remainder is not 0, I can say that x plus 1 is not a factor. Okay, and this is by the factor theorem. So this is how I solved for the value of k, and then I found whether x plus 1 is a factor or not. So again, let me pause the screen for a couple of minutes and then we will continue. Okay, let us continue with our next question. Okay, this is our next question. Determine the value of k for which this polynomial is exactly divisible by 1 minus 2x. So when it says it's exactly divisible, it means that 1 minus 2x is a factor of this given polynomial. So let us assign f of x to this polynomial. So f of x is 2x raised to 4. Minus kx cube plus 4x square plus 2x plus 1. Okay, and now it's given that this polynomial is exactly divisible by 1 minus 2x. So what is given to us is, it is given that 1 minus 2x is 1 minus 2x is a factor of f of x. What am I supposed to find in this question? I am supposed to find the value of k, right? This is what I am supposed to find. Now, since f of x is given and it's given that 1 minus 2x is a factor, I can go ahead and find the value of my a first. So to find the value of a, I will equate my divisor to 0. So that means 2x is equal to 1, which means x is equal to half, right? And therefore my a is half. So I can say that f of half is therefore equal to 0. This conclusion is based on my factor theorem, right? So now let's find out f of half. F of half means in place of x I have to substitute half. So it will be 2 into half raised to 4 minus k into half the whole cube plus 4 into half the whole square plus 2 into half plus 1, right? And this is equal to 0. So let us simplify things now. So this is 2 times 1 raised to 4 is 1 and 2 raised to 4 is 16 minus k into 1 cube is 1, 2 cube is 8 plus 4 times half square is 1 by 4. plus 2 into half is 1 plus 1 is equal to 0, right? So now 2 and 16 cancel by 2. So I get 1 by 8 minus k by 8. 4 and 4 cancel. So that's 1. And 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, is equal to 0. This means, let's transpose the k by 8 to the other side. So what I now get is, when I transpose k by 8 to the other side, I get 1 by 8 plus 3 is equal to k by 8. And therefore, multiplying by 8, I will get 1 plus 3 times 8 is 24 is equal to k, which means the value of k is 25. And hence, the value of k in this question is 25. So again, using the remainder, using the factor theorem, I was able to conclude that f of half was 0. And that is how I found the value of k in this question. Let me again pause for a couple of minutes. Okay, let's move on to our next question.